Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Thank you so much for joining us. My name is Astrid Morfitt. I'm the Assistant Registrar International Recruitment and Admission here at the University of Guelph. And we're super excited to welcome you to our Discover Food, Environment, and Agriculture at the University of Guelph. We're going to provide you with a lot of great opportunities to learn more about our programs and many other things about the University of Guelph, as well as ways to get in touch with us after the fact. If you are watching us live, please remember that towards the end of the webinar, you will have an opportunity to fill out a form which will allow you a ballot into the tuition credit draw. So that means that you need to stay until the very end, fill out the form, and then you will be put into the draw. If you are watching this as a recording, great, we're glad that you are. You will have an opportunity to attend our international virtual open house, which is scheduled for Saturday, January 20th, 2024, as well as any of our spring webinars in order to submit a ballot and be considered for the tuition credit as well. So to get us started, you do have the opportunity to submit any questions that you have through the Q&A. So do take advantage of that opportunity. We will answer questions throughout the webinar and towards the end if there are multiple questions that we didn't get to. So again, my name is Astrid Morfitt. I have the absolute pleasure of working for the University of Guelph with our international students. My team and I are tasked to basically support you every step of the way. So by providing you with information on our academics, on scholarships, bursaries, admission requirements, housing, sports, any extracurricular activities. So just a very wide overview of opportunities that are awaiting you. And then to also put you in contact with any of the staff and students on campus to provide you with additional information as well. So I graduated with a degree in Bachelor of Arts, Sociology and Political Science, a double major, and I am originally from Sarajevo, Bosnia and Herzegovina. So I moved to Canada during high school and completed high school as well as university here. And my reason why I loved University of Guelph is really the welcoming environment that focuses on the overall student experience. So we know that academics are super important, but we also know that you need to come to the university where you will feel at home, you will be supported, and you will be able to grow in so many different ways, and to be able to really work towards your future and all the different opportunities. So we're here to inform you about many, many of those opportunities today. So before we get started into all of the details, I would like to introduce you to my colleague, Christine, as well as our current international students who will be joining us throughout the webinar today.
Perfect, thank you so much, Astrid. My name is Christine and I'm the Student Recruitment Manager for the Ontario Agricultural College at the University of Guelph. I am also an alumni of the University of Guelph. I took the Bachelor of Arts degree program, majoring in international development, as well as a Master of Science in Capacity Development and Extension. I grew up in Milton, Ontario originally, which is just about half an hour, 45 minutes from Toronto. And my reason for choosing the University of Guelph was the welcoming community on campus, as well as all of the old buildings full of character and the green space. And then Guelph as a city also has a very small town feel to it, which you'll learn more about shortly, while still having all of the amenities you could possibly need. So I really fell in love with the campus and the city surrounding it as well. I'd like to take a moment to also introduce our student panelists. So they'll be sharing their experiences later on in the presentation. So I'll let Anya introduce herself first.
Hello, everyone. My name is Anya. I am a graduate of the Bachelor of Bioresource Management, where I majored in environmental management. Currently, I am pursuing my master at the University of Guelph. I stick around. And my hometown is Trinidad and Tobago. And now I'll pass it on to Pimpisa.
Hi, everyone. I'm Pimpisa, and I'm in my third year of food science and business co-op. And my hometown is from Bangkok, Thailand. I chose U of G because of their reputation of their food programs and the OAC. I really like this city too. So I think I made the right choice. I'll pass it on to Nidhi.
Oh, thank you. Hi, everyone. My name is Nidhi. I'm a fifth year student in bachelor's of sciences and environmental sciences, but I'm specifically majoring in environmental economics and policy. I am coming from India. However, I was born and brought up in Dubai, so kind of embedded in both the sides of the nation. The reason I did choose Guelph was because of the amazing co-op and collaborations that the university has in their programs.
Amazing. Thank you all. So stay tuned to the end of the presentation and we'll hear more from these international students about their experience at the University of Guelph. And I'll pass it back to Astrid.
Thank you very much, everyone. So why study at the University of Guelph? We're very proud to say that the University of Guelph is a beautiful campus. It is a safe campus. I love to call it a walking campus. It takes you about 10 minutes or so to walk from one end to the other end of the campus. What that means is that it is a quiet campus. There's not a lot of car traffic. You really have the opportunity to walk around, enjoy the new and old buildings, run into classmates, your professors, staff around the campus, and it really allows you the opportunity to feel at home and to feel comfortable much quicker. The University of Guelph is also a community within the city of Guelph itself. So there are a lot of wonderful things that we would like to introduce you to today. So when it comes to the University of Guelph, we have approximately 27,000 undergraduate students, of which 2,000 or so students are international students from 135 different countries around the world. We have three campuses that are associated with the University of Guelph. So our main campus in Guelph, Ontario, then we have the University of Guelph Humber campus in Toronto, as well as the Ridgetown campus in Ridgetown, Ontario. So all of us specialize in different areas and also provide you with opportunities to have a different experience dependent on the campus that you choose. So when it comes to the University of Guelph, we're a mid-sized university. And what that means is that we're large enough to provide you with a lot of opportunities. So we will talk about academic opportunities, different programs and majors and different ways that you can really create a unique academic experience for yourself. But we also receive the most amount of research funds from the government. So $183 million in annual research funding. So if you're into research, then that's amazing and exciting. But if you're not, that still will impact your experience at the university because you get to really benefit from top-notch professors who are conducting the research, top-notch facilities that are available to you, and just that experience of being able to stay on top of all of the great trends and exciting things that are happening in the world. We're top five comprehensive universities in Canada. And the reason for that is because not only are we academically strong, but we also offer undergraduate as well as graduate programs, including the Doctor of Veterinary Medicine program that you're going to hear about later on. And last but not least, you will hear about employment opportunities throughout the programs that we're going to cover today. But overall, as a university across all programs, 92% of our students are employed within 6 months of graduation. So the way to be able to do that is to really take advantage of the experiential learning opportunities, work study, co-op, and every other opportunity that you have to not only help fund your education, but also gain that work experience while you're studying. So in regards to the city itself, you can see where Guelph is located. We are one of Canada's top 10 places to live. We're a safe city. We're a smaller city. So really the university is part of our city. We all spend a lot of time on campus and off campus and really have the opportunity to sort of infiltrate ourselves in experiencing both of those communities together at the same time. So when it comes to the city of Guelph, we have a population of about 150,000 people, and then compare that to 27,000 students. So you know that we're a university city. There are a lot of different things that you can do, a lot of different social activities you can engage in, concerts, different sporting events. You can go on different hikes and walks and different parks around the university as well as within the city itself, and just really take in the four seasons that we offer to you during your studies at the University of Guelph. And if you're looking to get out of Guelph just to experience what's nearby, downtown Toronto is a great opportunity to go and watch sporting events, a play, for example, to catch a flight, to go back home or visit family, visit your friends. So we are about an hour away from Toronto. There is a direct bus that will take you right from the heart of the campus to downtown Toronto, as well as to the airport. So definitely very accessible and easy to go and explore. Niagara Falls is about 90 minutes away. So if you haven't been, definitely a place to check out once you arrive. And if you have a little bit of an adrenaline rush need and you like to spend time outside, go on rides and spend time with your friends, then Canada's Wonderland is about 75 minutes away. It's a great opportunity to spend any of your time off or weekends and just really enjoy and have some fun. So we spoke about funding your education. So first things first is when you apply to the University of Guelph, dependent on your citizenship, if you're a Canadian citizen or a permanent resident, and you're admissible, so you meet our admission criteria, we will automatically consider you for a domestic scholarship. If you're an international student paying international fees, therefore requiring a study permit to study at the University of Guelph, we will automatically consider you for an international entrance scholarship. So when it comes to the international entrance scholarships, they are based on your grades, so the admission grades that we use from high school, and they start at $6,500 in your first year, all the way up to $9,500. And then if you maintain 80% average and maintain to be a study permit student, then you could receive $4,000 in your second, third, and fourth year of studies. So again, these entrance scholarships do not require an application. As soon as you're admissible to the university, we will automatically consider you for those, and the information about your eligibility will be included in your offer letter. Now, if you are interested in actually applying for the President Scholarship, we have domestic and international versions. So the international version is the Dr. Franco J. Vaccarino President Scholarship. It is worth $42,500 over 4 years, and it is on top of any entrance scholarships that you are eligible for. Now, the big caveat about the President Scholarships is they do require an application. So the deadline, not only to apply to the university, submit all of your required documents, apply for the scholarship, and submit your references and any other supporting documents for the scholarship. You need to do all of that by January 25th, 2024. So it is imperative that you don't miss that deadline. We also have a couple of other scholarships that are available to you if you're coming directly from high school. However, do keep in mind that once you're in your second, third, fourth, fifth year, we have what are called in-course scholarships and bursaries. So those are available to upper year students. Some of them are very generic. Some of them are based on your grades. Some of them are based on the program or the specific major you're studying or the country that you might be from or a region that you're from. So definitely check those out once you're in your upper years as well. Funding your education is also very important through other means. So as international students, you are allowed to work part-time during the school year and full-time during your time off. So on our campus, we have approximately 4,500 part-time employment opportunities. So my team and I are lucky enough to have about 6 to 7 international students that work on our team every single year to support us in everything that we do. But students can also work part-time within the library, for a professor in a lab doing research, in hospitality, in housing, athletics, and so on. So whatever your passion and whatever your experience that you're searching for, you can find a number of jobs on campus, but you can also work off campus as well. During the pause in your studies, so let's say if you are taking the winter off, summer off, then you can work full-time. So part-time is generally about 15 to 20 hours a week, and full-time is about 35 to 40 hours a week. So just to give you a sense of how that works. And lastly, there are many other opportunities that you can get involved on campus. And if your program offers co-op, then definitely look into that. You will hear a lot more about it during our presentation, and then I will fill you in with some additional information later on as well. So when it comes to the University of Guelph, as I mentioned, we're large enough to offer you a lot of different opportunities and choices. So we have 16 different degree programs. So in my example, I completed a Bachelor of Arts degree, and then majors, we have over 75. So I did a double major, sociology and political science, because I really enjoyed both of those majors equally. But let's say you really are passionate about food and agriculture business, but you have a little bit of an interest in French studies or another minor, then you can combine different majors and minors once you get into your second year. So it really allows you to be flexible and to build your own degree in a way that resonates with you, but that will also make you much more employable and interesting to employers when it comes to applying to different positions while at the university, but also after graduation. So I will pass it back off to Christine. You're about to learn a lot about everything to do with food, environment, and agriculture at U of G. And I will be back later on to chat about a few other things.
Perfect. Thank you so much, Astrid. Just a reminder to everyone that's watching to use the Q&A tool to ask questions to not only myself, but also Astrid and our student panelists. We will be monitoring that and answering some questions during the panel portion of today's event. So now we'll get into more details around the programs in the areas of food, environment, and agriculture offered at the University of Guelph. So first I'll explain what the OAC or Ontario Agricultural College is. And other universities often separate into faculties, but we do things a little differently at U of G and call our faculties colleges. Therefore, we are the Faculty of Agriculture as the Ontario Agricultural College, or OAC for short. Something you need to see OAC is that we have programs on two campuses, main campus in Guelph and Ridgetown campus, which is about 2 hours southwest of Guelph. The OAC is internationally renowned for its research, teaching, and knowledge extension in the areas of food, agriculture, communities, and the environment, which we'll hear more about shortly. And the OAC encompasses a community of 3,700 diploma, undergraduate, and graduate students, as well as over 35,000 alumni. It was established in 1870 or 74 and was one of the founding colleges at the University of Guelph, therefore having a really deep and rich history. And we are celebrating our 150th next year, so that is really exciting that's coming up. We also have programs across 8 degree programs and 15 majors, as well as 6 associate diplomas. And the OAC is rated number 1 in Canada for food and agricultural sciences, so that's really exciting and important to note. So experiential learning opportunities at the University of Guelph are a big priority for several programs and courses, including programs within the OAC. Some of these opportunities include applied research courses, certificate programs, community engaged learning courses, course integrated and experiential learning, field courses, undergraduate research assistantships, and internships. I'll touch on some of these unique learning opportunities for specific programs later in our presentation, but I will also let our student panelists talk more about that as well. And co-op is another experiential learning opportunity available for specific programs, which I'll be pointing out today when we get to that point. So co-op is a really incredible opportunity for students to take part in when they come to the University of Guelph. As a co-op student, you will gain relevant work experience, build professional networks, and develop essential interpersonal skills needed to succeed in the workplace, all while getting paid and earning your degree at the same time. So this is really helpful in funding your tuition and funding your studies. In co-op, you will also have an in-class course to help you develop a resume and interview skills. And students are also assigned a co-op coordinator to assist them during their studies and during the employment process. So here is a sample co-op schedule for the food science program. You can see that you don't have your first co-op work term until the end of second year. And the second work term comes after third year and spans over 3 semesters, making it a year long. So that gives you more of an in-depth experience in a position or a company. You can either choose to work at one place for the whole entire year or do different terms for co-op positions, depending on what you're looking for. So choosing a post-secondary program isn't only about selecting what you want to study, but it's also, of course, about finding a job and starting your career once you do graduate. Here on the screen, you can see the logos of many companies that we see our graduates working for. These companies are based locally, provincially, nationally, and globally. We have students from food science working in product development for Mars, PepsiCo, Gailey, and many other food companies, for example. We've also seen graduates from the Bachelor of Science in Agriculture program work for John Deere, Bayer Crop Science, BASF, Syngenta, and more. And these are just a few examples of where our graduates work after they complete their programs, but there are opportunities everywhere you look, since food, agriculture, and the environment is really at the core of our society, and it's so, so important. So here's an overall snapshot of overall degree programs that we have in the OAC. As I mentioned, we cover 8 different degree programs and have 15 majors, and the ones with the red square indicate that they have a co-op option as well. So we'll go over these more in depth shortly. And then here are some of the other related majors at the University of Guelph under the College of Biological Sciences. So that includes nutritional and nutraceutical sciences, marine and freshwater biology, wildlife biology and conservation, zoology, and the Bachelor of One Health. I won't be covering these in detail today, but for more information, you can visit the CBS website, which we'll share in the chat there. And then today's presentation is really focusing on degree programs, but as I mentioned, the OAC also offers 6 different associate diploma programs across 2 campuses. So each are 2 years in length and also offer a co-op option in the summer between first and second year. We have the Associate Diploma in Agriculture, Environmental Technician, Equine Care and Management, Horticulture, and Veterinary Technology at our Ridgetown campus. And the Associate Diploma in Turfgrass Management option is taught at our Guelph campus. For more information on the Associate Diploma programs, just visit our website as well. And now I'll pass it over to my colleague Elizabeth to share a little bit about the Ontario Veterinary College at the University of Guelph.
Hi everyone, I'm Elizabeth Lowinger. I'm the Manager of Student Affairs at the Ontario Veterinary College. So hopefully you love animals as much as I do and you love science. So that might mean that you have a future in veterinary medicine. So if you're considering being a veterinarian, our school is a great option for you. It's the oldest school in North America, and it was established in 1862, and it's ranked number 1 in Canada and number 3 in North America for veterinary science. So we have a great reputation worldwide. We're accredited by the AVMA and the CVMA, which means the education you get here is exactly on par with other schools in the US and Canada. And it means that once you're done here, you can pretty much work anywhere. We have close to 0 attrition and tons of support for you once you start the program, which means that if you start the vet program at our school, you will be a veterinarian. We have 100% employment rate after graduation. There's a huge need for veterinarians right now, all over North America and in the world. So this is a great time to consider being a veterinarian. And there's so many different things you can do with the degree. There's a very high success rate of our students in the licensing exam that you have to write in order to have patients. And you can apply in your second year, after your second year of university. So that means that you don't have to finish your bachelor's degree, save on tuition, and go into the vet school. And we accept 15 international non-Canadian students every year into the program. So these are the requirements for entry to the veterinary program here at Guelph. You have to finish at least 2 years full time of a bachelor's degree, but it can be any major. So some of the options are with an OAC. Our biggest feeder program right now is animal biology, and certainly it's a very attractive major for people who want to be a veterinarian. What could be better than animal biology for someone who wants to be a veterinarian, right? And then while you're in university, there are 8 courses that we want you to take. So there's 3 biologies, and 1 has to be a cell biology, genetics, biochemistry, statistics, and 2 humanities, social sciences. And those courses are very easy to take in all of the majors here at the University of Guelph. They're usually part of the program, and if they're not, they're very easy to take as electives. So once you're here, you can very much apply to the vet program. And then there's a CASPER assessment, which is an online assessment so you take that measures soft skills that are required for the veterinary profession. And of course, you need to do your veterinary experience, your animal experience, and get some of work or volunteer experience working with people, because everyone will tell you that veterinary medicine is not just about the animals, it's also about working with people, because every animal you're going to work with comes with a human attached.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Elizabeth. So Elizabeth will be sticking around in the background to answer any questions that come up about the DVM program, so feel free to pop those in the Q&A as well. So now we'll jump into some more details about the undergraduate programs within the OAC. And first, I'll talk about the Bachelor of Science in Agriculture program. The Bachelor of Science in Agriculture is a unique program because you enter it undeclared and don't choose your major until second year, meaning your first year is common for all students in this degree program. The 4 majors you could select from include Honors Agriculture, Animal Science, Crop Science, and Horticulture. This program allows for a lot of flexibility, and international exchange or semester abroad opportunities are available, as well as independent research courses, field courses, and experiential learning credits. This program combines life sciences and agricultural practices with specialized skills and experiences. The co-op program is also available as an option for students that want to pursue co-op. Some of those learning opportunities for this program include the experiential learning or experiential education course and the agriculture internship course, where students complete 40 hours of work in their area of interest that counts towards a course credit. There are also a variety of field courses students can partake in, including the crop science field trip, where students tour the Midwestern United States just prior to the start of the fall semester before their fourth year. They visit cash crop, horticultural, and livestock farms and supporting industries such as processing, manufacturing, elevators, and stockyards. And then alternately, the field course in international agriculture course introduces students to a wide range of tropical and subtropical agricultural production systems and issues. This course is comprised of a weekly 3-hour evening lecture and a 10-day field trip to Costa Rica, where students will visit corporate and individual farms, as well as university and government research stations. So many, many experiential learning opportunities within this degree program. So now I'll share a short video showcasing a student named Aresta. So she was a Bachelor of Science in Agriculture student, and she's just gonna share what she experienced in the program.
As a child, I always made a point of never wanting to say I don't know when someone asked me what I wanted to be when I grew up. And I think at age 10, I was definitely looking up towards my mom, and I knew I wanted to do something science-based. My name is Arasta Haverick, and I'm a fourth-year student majoring in honors agriculture, and my minor is creative writing. In agriculture science, you're exposed very early on into classes that would help you both with animal agriculture and plant agriculture. And although I loved animals, I realized very early on that I didn't have to make a career with them in order to continue liking them. I found some amazing professors in the plant agriculture department and in plant sciences in general. They taught me a lot, or everything really I know about the field and the subject, and they offered me a lot of opportunities. I could go to class and learn something completely new, and it wouldn't feel like I was in class. It would feel like I'm just listening to a TED talk on something I'm interested in.
The Bachelor of Science in Agriculture program is designed to introduce people to agriculture. You don't necessarily need an agricultural background to be successful in the program. If we look across the province, the agri-food system as a business competes with the auto industry for being the leading employer in the province. So there are literally thousands and thousands of jobs in the agri-food sector, and our program is designed to introduce students to that sector through the science of agriculture and prepare them for a career in producing food and distributing food, bringing food to people, and just participating anywhere in the food production system.
You can come in not knowing exactly what you want to do, and by the end of your first year, you will have taken plant science courses and animal science courses, and then if you still don't know what you want to do, you can just choose honors agriculture and get the best of both worlds.
All right, so next up is the Bachelor of Science degree program. So within this program, you can choose from a pretty extensive list of majors, but the three I'll be focusing on today as part of the OAC include food science, plant science, and animal biology. So firstly, animal biology is built on a foundation of core sciences, including chemistry, physics, and biology. Students in this program will explore genetics, physiology, behavior, welfare, and nutrition. Students will develop an understanding of animal production systems, meaning industries like dairy, beef, pork, and poultry. And this program includes hands-on labs and field trips to learn about each respective industry as well. During their first year, students will take courses to build their foundation in science. And in their upper years of study, students will have many courses that dive deeper into more specific topics, including reproduction, species-specific nutrition, behavior, and welfare. Most courses will focus on production animal species. However, there are courses in senior years of study on companion animals, wildlife, as well as fish and crustacea. And as Elizabeth mentioned, this is one of the common programs that students will take to explore the pathway to the DBM program at OBC. And plant science students in the plant science major will explore plants through the studies of growth, development, and physiology. This program also offers hands-on learning in labs and through independent research courses and field trips. I'm also happy to let you know that the co-op option is available for this program as well. And electives and restricted electives will shape the plant science major and allow students to focus on their interests specifically. Some of these electives include weed science, issues in agriculture and landscape management, wine grape culture, plants, the environment and society, the world of viruses, plant anatomy and growth and development, and research projects. And then lastly, in the Bachelor of Science degree program, Food science is built on a foundation of core sciences, including chemistry, physics, and microbiology. Students in this program will explore food processing, product development, packaging, quality, and safety. And I do want to point out that food science is not culinary training or dietetic studies. Instead, it's its own field of study that incorporates elements of nutrition and cooking. With this program, the co-op option, as I mentioned, is available as well. And this is an incredible learning opportunity and prepares students for future employment. So many of our students that take the co-op option often find jobs before they even graduate, often from past employers that they had during their co-op. And next I'll share a quick video featuring Krupa. She's a food science student from India, and she was part of leading a project to develop hot honey on campus at the Guelph Food Innovation Center.
Hi, I'm Krupa Thakkar. I'm from India and I'm studying food science at the University of Guelph. I chose the University of Guelph because it is well known for having the best food science program in Canada. The quality of education is very high and it offers experiential learning opportunities as well. Not to mention, it also has the best campus food in Canada. One of the things I absolutely love about my program is the incredible support system. The professors, the staff, and fellow students are all in for your success. It's a community that constantly cheers you on. Experiential learning is a big part of my food science co-op program. Currently, I'm working as a food product development technician at the Guelph Food Innovation Center. I recently got to lead a project creating hot honey, overseeing both the food product development and the production side of it. It's hands-on, it's exciting, and it's the kind of learning that really elevates my education. Living in Canada has been such an enriching experience. I have met people from all over the world and learned about many different cultures. I've also made so many lifelong friends and many memories. Some advice I can give for other international students at U of G is to seize every opportunity that comes your way. University of Guelph has so many opportunities and resources, and you want to make sure you make the most of your time here. Whether it's joining clubs or taking part in events, these experiences not only enhance your journey, but also contribute to building connections and skills that can last a lifetime.
All right, I do really want to try that hot honey. It sounds amazing. So next up is the Bachelor of Science in Environmental Sciences. And like the Bachelor of Science in Agriculture, the first year of the Bachelor of Science in Environmental Science degree program is common. So after your first year, students will pick from four different majors, including ecology, environment and resource management, environmental economics and policy, and environmental sciences. And this degree also has the co-op option. So in the ecology major, students will learn about ecosystems and explore conservation issues like habitat loss and animal endangerment. In environment and resource management, approaches environmental science from a social science perspective. Environmental economics and policy integrates economics and law to environmentally based problems and studies how markets and policy can influence human behavior. But I'll let Nadi share more about that when we get to the panel portion. And then finally, environmental science explores the biosphere, hydrosphere, and atmosphere and kind of encompasses all areas of the environment. Field courses and independent study projects are a highlight of this degree program, and various courses use the environment and outdoors as their classroom. The University of Guelph is also home to the Arboretum, and many courses will actually go out into the Arboretum for their class and study the trees and the plants that are in pretty much our backyard at the University of Guelph campus. So the brand new Bachelor of Indigenous Environmental Science and Practice program is a science degree program with an environment focus that blends Western science with Indigenous knowledge systems. Courses will address Indigenous knowledge systems, land-based teachings, and Indigenous settler relations in Canada. It includes theoretical and applied aspects of environmental sciences and technology management and land use policy development practices. Some of the highlights include field trips to Indigenous communities, land-based instruction, interactive labs, and participation in discussion circles and ceremony. And the co-op stream is available with this program as well. So the next program we'll talk about is the Bachelor of Bioresource Management degree program. The degree Bachelor of Bioresource Management, BBRM for short, we love our abbreviations here at the university, is unique to the University of Guelph. It is a combination of business with sciences, and it was really born from a need of industry employers because they wanted students to have that business background while also having the science background at the same time. In this program, students will combine environmental or equine sciences with business and economics. Students gain practical and theoretical experience, develop leadership and problem-solving skills, and work with industry mentors and partners to bring their ideas to life. International field studies are an option, as well as the co-op option is also available. Some highlights of the equine management major include a herd of six teaching horses that students routinely use in their courses while learning about management, Handling, and Health of Equine. Class sizes in this program are typically smaller in size of about 30 to 40 students per cohort, which creates an amazing opportunity to develop good connections with professors teaching these courses and your colleagues within the cohorts. After all, the industry is ultimately quite small, and it's great to know people and get to know others studying similar things as you. Students in the environmental management program will learn through practical and theoretical experiences to grow their understanding of environmental science and technology and business. Students will develop leadership and problem-solving skills through field trips, experiential learning in the workplace, and independent research. And I'll let Anya share more about that when we get to the panel as well. So landscape architecture integrates people with the natural environment. It is the art of science of designing and conserving land, water, and air for human and non-human use and enjoyment. The Bachelor of Landscape Architecture is a professional degree, and in turn, we receive accreditation approval from the Canadian Society of Landscape Architects that reviews our faculty, curriculum, resources, and facilities to make sure that they're aligned with the needs of the profession. So the rigorous review needed for the BLA has led other universities to alter their degree offerings, leaving the University of Guelph as the only institution in Canada capable of offering a BLA degree. The program is one of the most competitive undergraduate academic programs at the University of Guelph, receiving over 500 applications from across Canada and around the globe per year. In their third year, students can either take part in an international exchange or an internship. And the practice and study of landscape architecture is rooted in the value of community. Lifelong friendships develop in through small cohorts and dedicated spaces for students within the landscape architecture building. And most importantly, there is such a diversity of practice areas that everyone finds their passion in their kind of area within landscape architecture. So we have two programs left to chat about. So they're related to business and economics within the OAC. And the first is a Bachelor of Arts majoring in Food, Agricultural, and Resource Economics, also known as FAIR. In the FAIR program, students learn skills to deal with issues in food, agriculture, and resource management, both at local and global scales. This program involves advanced projects and many case-based courses where students can apply what they're learning to real-world issues. And students can choose to specialize in food and agribusiness management, international development economics, resource economics, or food industry management. International field studies, again, are an option with this program. And the co-op stream is available for students to pursue if they want to do that. And then the last program we'll talk about today is the Bachelor of Commerce, majoring in Food and Agricultural Business, also known as FAB. You'll see that a lot of our programs have abbreviations with them. This is a business degree, and in this program, students will acquire analytical and management skills to analyze and understand food trends. Students will explore topics related to value and supply chains, local and global markets, and how policy can affect competitiveness. Project and case-based courses are a highlight of this program where students can enhance their entrepreneurial skills. And again, co-op is available with this degree program. So why would you want to pursue a degree within the areas of food, environment, and agriculture in the Ontario Agricultural College at the University of Guelph? The first reason that I talked about earlier is that the OAC is rated number one for food and agricultural science in Canada. So that's a pretty big and an important number. We also have a very welcoming community at the University of Guelph, but especially within the OAC. An abundance of student clubs and activities make it really easy to meet new people and have fun during your studies. So for example, students can take part in dairy, poultry, swine, and beef science clubs, botany club, weeds club, soil and crop club, future vets club, animal science society, the student federation of the OAC, varsity sports teams, and intramurals, just to name a few. But I'll let our student panelists tell you more about their campus involvement shortly when we get to the panel. And then due to our vast and strong alumni base that I touched on earlier, there are over 687 awards given out to students in OAC programs each year, totaling over $1.5 million Canadian dollars. And experiential learning opportunities are a highlight of many of the programs within OAC. And again, I'll let our students speak more about that in a moment here. The last but certainly not least reason for why you might want to study in OAC is that there are four jobs for every one of our graduates entering Ontario's food and agricultural sector. So there are tons of job opportunities that many students receive offers of employment before they've even graduated due to the strong network within the agricultural industry and its related sectors of food, animals, environment, and communities. So now we'll move into our student panel, and this is where I wanna remind you to ask questions using the Q&A tool located on your dashboard. So we'll kick things off with our first question, and that is, why did you choose to come to the University of Guelph? And we'll start with Anya.
All right. So I chose to come to the University of Guelph, particularly for its strong environmental programs. I like the vibrant campus community, the amount of green spaces that were available, as well as the delicious food. And there are no numerous opportunities for personal as well as professional growth.
Perfect, thank you. And Pisa?
Hi, for me, I chose Guelph because of two things. First is the academics, and second is the environment. So for the academics, Guelph is well known for its food science program. It's like one of the best programs offered in Guelph. And I really enjoy this program. There's a lot to learn. I learned food packaging, food processing, and there's so many interesting courses, and I get to do some hands-on lab as well. And for the environment, I really like this city. It's a safe and green city. Everything is more of a slow-paced environment, and I really enjoy walking around in the arboretum and getting to explore nature here. That's why I chose Guelph. Yeah.
Thank you. And Nidhi?
Yeah, as I kind of said that before in my introduction, I did come to University of Guelph because of the amazing co-op, and I knew I wanted to study environmental sciences, and I wanted to integrate that with the not just the program academically, but also with the industry, and the University of Guelph had one of the best platform for that integration.
Perfect. Thank you so much. The next question I have for you all is, what was the transition like moving to Canada slash Guelph? And we'll start with Anya again.
Sure. Well, when I came to Guelph in 2019, it was my first time being so far away from home. And one of the most helpful programs that I've had to smoothen my transition when I came, I would say, would have been the Start International program that I've done. It's a week-long orientation dedicated to incoming international students. And it was really good, like socializing with other people, sharing a similar experience as myself, leaving home. And a lot of the friends that I have today have come from that program, from that orientation. So yeah, I would definitely recommend all incoming students to definitely check that out. It smoothens things over.
Perfect. Thank you, Anya. And Pimpiza, same question for you.
My transition was super smooth. For international students, the orientation is like really helpful. So make sure you attend and you join the Link Partner Program. That's where I met Anya there, and I get to socialize, and she showed me around campus and have a really good time together. And there's also a bunch of like resources. I'm also part of International Students Organization. So you always get to feel like you're not alone here. There's so many friends here who are experiencing the same thing as you. Yep.
Perfect, thank you. And Nidhi?
Again, I just want to reinforce on what both the panelists said. Start International was one of my greatest experience as well when I did come in 2019. You get all of the resources that you ever need in that 1 week long space of orientations that the university does put forward for our incoming international students. Alongside, we also have international student advisors. So if you're ever confused, lost, wondering what to do, they are always available for appointments and check-in. So check them out if you are coming to the university.
Awesome, thank you. And Anya, what kind of things are you involved in on campus, and how has student life been for you since coming here?
Currently, I am involved as the International Student Representative on the Graduate Student Association. But during my undergrad, I was involved in the Link program where I, as Pimpisa said, I met her. And that really links a upper year international student with a incoming international student. You get to like show them around campus and really just usher them into the town. As well as I was involved in the Caribbean Culture Club, doing social events and attending meetings to meet other Caribbean students. So yes.
Awesome. And Pimpiza?
That's what I believe in, but I always get involved whenever I get the opportunity to. Right now, I'm the vice president of Food Science Club, and we arrange bi-weekly meetings. We invite all the industry professionals. We had one last week. We invited Sleeman Breweries, but before we also invited Cargill or Lactalis, every food industry, you know. They're all here to attend our meetings and then talk to the students about their career opportunities and about our future goal and how should we do, or what should we do to reach that goal. It's really helpful. I think the community here is very supportive, and you will never feel like you're not a part of them. So just go out of your comfort zone, socialize, and make sure you get involved at school.
Great, thank you. Anidhi?
I feel like that's a question which I could write volumes on, but currently the couple of things I'm involved in, I am a student senator for second year now for the Bachelor's of Environmental Sciences program. So I do sit on Senate. I'm also involved with the Sustainability Office at the University of Guelph very extensively, which is a little hub on campus that do run a lot of student-run and campus-wide sustainability initiatives. And I've been with them since my first year. And I'm also a tour guide on campus. So if you're an international student coming into a new fall in love with our campus, you do have the opportunities to show it to other prospective students as well.
Amazing. Thank you so much, Nidhi. That's really great how involved you are on campus. My next question is, what experiential learning opportunities have you had during your program? And this kind of involves like your courses and the things you've taken part in as part of your program. And we'll start with Anya.
Sure. So most of my experiential learning opportunities have been within courses. During my undergrad, I've done tree ID for local Canadian type trees. I've done forest inventories within the Arboretum for a forest ecology class. I've also done soil sampling from the Arboretum to throughout various places within Southern Ontario for my soil variability and land evaluation class. It is a long name. But yeah, you do get those opportunities to get those hands-on fieldwork components as well.
And you get to explore different areas outside of campus as well, which is a really great opportunity.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah. Pimpiza, how about you? What kind of experiential learning opportunities have you had during your courses and your program?
With my major, you get to pick many electives, and all of them are like hands-on full lab experience. You can choose like dairy processing, meat processing, and you get to work in the pilot plant that we have at school. If you're not taking that class, you also have the opportunity to join the hot sauce team or the hot honey. We went to the pilot plant. We grow the chili seeds from, we grow the chili from the seeds, and then we process them and then we sell them. It's a really fun project where you can work on. And there's also co-op opportunity that it's really useful for your career. Last summer, I was working in Mississauga for a chicken manufacturing company. I really learned a lot from that 4 months that I think would last me a lifetime. And if you get to do co-op, I would totally recommend you to branch out and get to learn a lot from your industry.
Awesome, thank you. Anidhi, same question for you.
So I would say most of the experiential learning opportunities I've had in my program in my very little environmental economics and policy program is from the co-op, which was very, very helpful on both my personal as well as professional development, because it does provide you that opportunity to go out in the field and kind of look into what specific niches you're very much interested in. I also had the opportunity to work this summer as an international student, a summer undergraduate research assistant with the Ontario Agricultural College, which was another experiential learning opportunity mentioned by Christine in the beginning of the presentation. So there are a lot of opportunities for international students to get involved within campus, and I would say research opportunities was one of my highlights.
Amazing. On that note, do you know, you're in your fifth year now, do you know what you plan to do after you graduate in the spring?
Yes, I am planning into getting back in the industry. So I did actually work at Corteva Agriscience for 8 months for my co-op, and they have offered me a position to get back to them once I do graduate. However, I'm still kind of looking at my options.
Amazing. Good for you. Congratulations. It's very exciting. I'll be curious to see where you end up, and I'm sure your future is bright in that area.
Thank you.
What is living in the city of Guelph like for you? How has that been for you? Anya, we'll start with you for this question.
Sure. Guelph has been a welcoming city. It offers that small town type of vibe for international students. I'd say it's the environment is definitely safe and inclusive. You can feel comfortable walking down the street at night. The landscape is very, very picturesque. There's a lot of green spaces dotted throughout the city. So if you're into enjoying nature, there's definitely those opportunities as well. But yeah, I find the city is small town, but there is a lot going on. You follow the Downtown Guelph page, you're seeing activities every weekend. So I like that sense of community within Guelph.
Excellent. And Pimpisa, same question for you.
Similar to Anya, I really love the city. So before coming here, my mom actually researched the city beforehand because, you know, 19-year-old girl, you're going to study abroad on the other side of the world. She has to do a lot of research on the city I'm studying in. And Guelph is like one of the safest and green city. And it is really true. Like, I feel very safe walking around at night alone. And there's a lot of things to do here, a lot of things to eat. And if I ever feel homesick, I can always go to Toronto. It's like an hour and a half from here. And there's a bunch of things to do that if you would like more of like fun and entertainment. So I really like the city. I'm planning to stay here longer if I can.
Amazing. And Nidhi, same question.
Yeah, I feel like I resonate with both of you. Living in the city of Guelph has been really, really beautiful. Whenever the climates to like right now today, it's snowing and it's still very, very beautiful. And just the community there outside of the campus too, everyone's so friendly. There's so many spaces, there's so many things as a student just living in this town one is able to do. One of my favorite activity to do is actually go on long walks in the Arboretum, which is right within our campus, and not a lot of campuses have that. However, I'm glad we have that right on our kind of area, which I really enjoy.
Amazing. One other thing that I also love about the city of Guelph is the food. And I think that's a big draw for a lot of people is the amazing food options that cover kind of all cultural and dietary needs in that area. So I love all the restaurants downtown and kind of within the city of Guelph as well as on campus. The options on campus are tremendous, and I really like the food that's on campus. My next question is, what do you like most about your programs? This is a chance for you to share more about your program and what you're currently or have studied. And we'll start with Anya again for this one.
Yeah. So during my bachelor's, I really enjoyed working together with people within my program. The BBRM environmental management program and major tends to be a bit on the smaller side, so you get to really know the people within your program and build a strong sense of community because you're sharing a lot of courses with these people. So I found that the collaboration aspect was really one of my favorite aspects within my bachelor program.
Great. Pimpisa, same question.
My program is like a combination of food science and business management. So in my first and second year, you get to learn like a mix of like biology, chemistry, but also on the other side, which is accounting and statistic, economics. So you're very like complete bunch of knowledge about the food industry, just not about the production, but also the business part. So I really enjoyed it so far. In my third and fourth year, I'm looking forward to my full year co-op that is happening next summer. And you get a lot of hands-on experience in the lab. So I really liked it.
Yeah, that's great. One thing about kind of the food science area too that I love is that you can eat your experiments if you want to in many cases. So I think that's a big draw as well is the food portion of that, which we've talked lots about today. Needy, same question for you.
I'm specifically majoring in environmental economics and policy, which is again one of that nicher programs within the environmental sciences degree. And what I love about my specific major is the integration that happens from your theoretical learning of sciences and economics into you looking at the policy implementation side, which I personally have found really rewarding. And on top, there are so many ways, as Christine said before, for you to make those connections with other minors and certificates as well. Like for personally me, I declared a minor in my third year in sustainable business because I was leaning more towards that sustainability side of things, and also certificate in leadership, which was again, I'm really excited to graduate with multiple designations. And the connections that the professors and the Ontario Agricultural College itself has with the industry is very vast, and you will notice that when you do get into one of those Ontario agricultural programs.
Amazing. Thank you very much for sharing that. What advice do you have for future students coming to the University of Guelph? This is our kind of final question to end the panel off with. And again, we'll start with Anya and end with Nadine.
So my biggest piece of advice to incoming students is I want to stress the importance of staying organized. I would suggest using a planner or using a calendar online to just organize your schedule and keep track of deadlines because it is you're in charge of yourself, so you really have to work on self-management. And definitely work on your work-life balance. Remember that you have to take care of yourself in order to be able to give. So remember to set aside time, or whether it be hitting the gym, going to see a movie, or going for a walk or something, but remember to still prioritize yourself and make that necessary time for your mental well-being.
For sure, that self-care time is super important for your success in your program and just in your general day-to-day life. Pimpisa, same question for you.
Since Annie already talked about the self-care and self-management part of things, I'm going to talk about how to seize opportunities. So I think if you have the opportunities to do something, to join, to be a part of some events, always go for it. And just make sure you leave your comfort zone and try something new. It's not going to work out every time, but you will learn from it and you get to experience most here in the university. You will get so many connections and you'll grow so much in within 4 years.
Yeah, amazing. Nidhi, same question.
Yep, just to reinforce on that, for international students specifically, I would really advise don't get shy, don't be scared. I know it's a new place, but there's so many opportunities for you to get involved. We have 150 plus clubs and organizations on campus. We have one thing for everyone. So you're in a new place, take advantage of it, look for new opportunities, get immersed in them, and do different things to find your footing. And once you do find it, you will know where to go from there.
For sure. Thank you. I always do like to say too, It's not all about what you learn in your courses, but it's about what you learn outside of your classes. So definitely get involved and take part in all the things you possibly can, because it goes by so quickly and you're going to wish you could have it all back. But so yeah, seize every opportunity that you possibly can. So that kind of concludes our panel for today. I will pass it back to Astrid in a moment, but thank you so much to our panelists for sharing your experiences at the University of Guelph. I'm sure a lot of you learned from them and took some advice from them as well. So thank you all.
Thank you very much, everyone. That was so much great information. Before we take the next steps, if you will, just a couple of things. A reminder that if you do have any questions, please utilize the Q&A section, and we will be able to answer those questions for you. And lastly, just a reminder in regards to the tuition credit. So make sure that you stay with us until the very end in order to be able to submit your information if you're joining us live for a ballot towards the tuition credit. So next steps, we've provided you with a lot of information, and trust me, there's a lot more information that we can chat about. What I would like you to do is, in order to make informed decisions on your next steps and programs and majors that you're interested in, definitely go on our website and visit the online academic calendar. It will provide you with an opportunity to look through the courses that you will take in each semester of every single degree program that we offer. And once you do that, I trust that you will be able to find certain programs and majors that really resonate with you, and then others that you're thinking, I thought that was really interesting until I found out which courses I would have to take in my degree. So one thing to remember is that many of our programs are offered, or degree programs, I should say, are offered as 4-year honors or 5-year co-op. Academically, they're identical, so there are no differences, but the co-op programs will take you 5 years to complete the exact same 4-year honors degree because it has the 3 to 5 co-op terms that are intertwined within your degree. So definitely do some research. As you're thinking about applying, if you're considering co-op, I urge you to apply to co-op. If you change your mind and you say, you know what, I'd rather complete the 4-year honors degree and not the co-op, then you can definitely leave co-op and be in regular. It's just much more difficult and more competitive to go from a regular degree to a co-op. So if you're even considering it and your program and major offer the co-op option, I urge you to apply to co-op directly. Now, how do you apply? So if you're a Canadian citizen or a permanent resident residing anywhere in the world, you will be required to apply through the Ontario University's Application Centre, or the OUAC. That is the way that you can apply to any Ontario universities. If you are an international student who will require a study permit to study at the University of Guelph, then you actually have 3 different ways that you can apply. One is directly through our website. The other is through the Ontario University's Application Centre, if you're applying to other Ontario universities. And if you're considering applying to universities in the United States, then you can actually check off U of G on the Common App. So a lot of different ways to select. You can apply to up to 3 different choices. So that could be 3 different degrees, 3 different majors. So definitely apply to any of the programs that you're considering after doing some additional research. Based on our admission requirements, you will receive an offer of admission to any and all of those up to 3 options. And then it is up to you to decide which one you would like to accept by the deadline to accept. So we'll chat about that right now. So when it comes to our important dates, all the information is available online. It will also be communicated to you within your offer letter as well as by email, but definitely keep an eye on important and upcoming dates. So January 15th is the application deadline for early admission. And what that means is if you would like to hear from the University of Guelph sooner, then we urge you to submit an application sooner. So by January 15th. If you're planning on applying for one of the President's Scholarships, then definitely apply by January 15th, because you will only have until January 25th to apply to the university, submit all the required documents, apply for the scholarship, and submit all of the required supporting documents, including reference letters for the scholarship. So you can start those applications now, but we will not accept any after the deadline. So January 25th is a strong deadline for the scholarship applications. Now, March 1st is the regular application deadline. What that means is any student who applies to the University of Guelph to any program or major by March 1st, if you meet our admission criteria, you will be guaranteed a space in your program and major. If you submit your application after March 1st, then you're taking a risk that maybe some of the programs or majors will be full. So I definitely would recommend submitting that application by March 1st, unless, of course, you're applying for the President's Scholarship. So then you need to submit it before January 25th. If you're completing high school inside of Canada, you will be required to accept your offer of admission by June 3rd, 2024. If you're completing high school outside of Canada, your deadline to accept your offer of admission will be May 1st, 2024. If you're interested in residence, we are guaranteeing residence to all international students. So that way you will need to submit your application and your $750 deposit by June 3rd to guarantee a space in residence. So there are a lot of other things that are available on our website. There are a lot of different support systems that we have for you. A couple that I would like to outline for you would be the International UniBuddy Student Ambassador Program that will allow you to chat one-on-one with our current international students. The website is available. It will show you all the different profiles of our current students based on the program and major they're in, based on the country they're from. So there's a great opportunity for you to connect with one or multiple students in order to really ask those one-on-one questions that you may or may not feel comfortable asking our staff. You can also schedule one-on-one appointments, so virtual meetings with our full-time staff. So either you yourself, you could have your friends join, your family join, whatever works for you, but we're more than happy to guide you throughout this process and to really be there for you every step of the way during the discovery, the application admission process, and then all the way to joining us at the University of Guelph. So as all of our current international students have mentioned, I wanted to echo the Start International orientation. I can tell you it is by far one of my most favorite times on campus. Each August, we get together. This year, we had the most students that we've ever had join us. It was over 600 students. So these are international students from all over the world who are either joining us right after high school, so as semester one students, as transfer students, as graduate students, or exchange students. And really having all of our incoming international students be in one room, it just brings so much excitement to the campus. It's so vibrant. You get to really start making friends right there and then. You can meet students from your country, sometimes from your school, as well as from your region, and then in many cases, students from countries that you've never been to and might never visit. So it's really an opportunity to network and make those relationships. So in regards to additional information, please do connect with us. Our information is on our website, and also follow us on social. So if you're on Instagram, YouTube, TikTok, WeChat, we're there. We're updating a lot of information and just really want you to learn as much as possible about the University of Guelph, but all of the opportunities, as I mentioned, not only academic, but also opportunities pertaining to sports, extracurricular activities, employment opportunities, financing opportunities, so that we can make sure that you have the best experience at the University of Guelph and that you're really prepared for the next steps in your adventure. So thank you again for joining us. It was an absolute pleasure, and definitely have a wonderful day and reach out to us with any questions.
Amazing. Thank you so much, Astrid. And thank you everyone for being part of our panel and speaking today. Best of luck with your pathway planning, and we hope to see you on campus next year or in the future.